Welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett and we're going to look now at adding practical functions to our project script. So we've seen that we can create functions, so we're going to use them in our project script now to create and delete users from files. As always, you can see these videos on theurbanpenguin.com. If you're on Twitter, you can follow me at theurbanpenguin. So within our project script for creating and deleting users in our Linux environment, our Python script is starting to grow now, and we're going to look at adding in functions and extra options such as the expire date for our user accounts. So our script has changed a little bit since you last saw it. I've added in a function here, we can see it, called createUser, that takes two parameters, the user and expiry days. Pretty much though, the code is the same as it was from where we saw it before, and it was stuck behind our add user option. The reason why we've created a function for this is that we're going to need it both in the add function and the add from file function. So putting all of our code within one block makes it easier to maintain. So one addition then to our create user function is that we've added in the expiry date. Before, we were hard coding it to 5 days. So we've got this option edays, which we're passing through then to our user add command. So we've got the user add minus e now. But if we jump down and look at how we're managing this, so moving down to our option to add users, we can see that we're scrolling through our users in our argument, passing then through the create user and the expire days. The expire days is a variable that is either based on the default value of 5 that I've assigned to it, or reading in then args.expire, which then becomes the minus e option that we have added into our parser. So we've got the add argument, the parser add argument, and we've got the minus e. We're also forcing this to be an integer, so I don't have to worry about string conversions when we're reading in the information. Additional functionality that we've also added in is this grep function that we've put in. I'm calling it the grep function, but we looked at this in our previous recording where we're looking at how functions work. So we're looking for the line then beginning with the user and immediately followed by a colon, and then we print the line. So we're getting positive affirmation that we have created the user once we run through the function. Another new function that you can see I've added in is a function, a user-defined function that I've got here called openFile, with the argument of a file. So we can use that with an additional argument that I've added in, where we're going to add from a file, so the minus f or the minus minus add from file option. I'm also going to add an option where we can remove users from the file, or users based from the file. So there's a way of getting a list of users in, so we can read our users from a file. So we looked at this before when we were printing out usernames to the screen, and we want to make sure that as before we're ignoring empty lines. So we've got a little if statement here that will ignore empty lines. And we saw when we were printing out before in our little test build-up that the read lines created a trailing new line character, so we're just making sure with our strip that we're removing any additional characters to the right of the string. And then as we go through, we can then be adding users from the file or deleting users from the file. Certainly if I'm deleting users from a file, I'm not going to need the expire days. I already have put in place the mechanism for adding our users from a file, so I've got my option minus f or minus minus add from file. And then if we look at the arguments for that, open file, args, add from file, we can see then that's all in place. So we go through and save our changes, and then from the command line I can go through and run the script. So with this, we're going to test it with the minus f to make sure it's creating our users from a file, and we'll also check that the ordinary add is working as well. So we put it through, we'll point through to our file 1, And we can put the expire days in as well if we want. So we can have, let's say, minus E for our expire days. And we can put anything we want. So I'll put, let's say, 75 or something like that in here. So as we go through and execute this, of course, I'm going to be prompted for the root user's password, which I'll try and type in correctly today. But we can then see that we're creating then those users, Abraham, Calvin, John, Bill, and Ronald. And we're getting the positive affirmation by going through then using the starts with user and colon. We get then Abraham, Calvin, John, Bill, Ronald, etc., printing out from searching from the password file, showing they've been created. But of course, this functionality is now within our user-defined function, and that's being called by the same mechanism when I go minus A, and here we've created then just the single user from the command line, Joe, and seeing that same positive affirmation. So pretty much we have off to a T adding users, but we're going to create a function to delete users. We're going to need to delete users a bit like creating users, both from input file and from input parameters at the command line. So anything that we do in one area needs to be repeated in the other. So this is where our functions are going to come in. So I don't need the comments, but we can put a comment in, tell us that we're removing users. We can define then the function, so I'm going to call it del user, and we'll take one parameter being the user. We start our code block, and the content of the code block can come from our existing area where we're deleting our users. So if I move down to our args.delete, I don't need the looping structure, but I just need the print deleting users and then the user del os.system shell output. So as we then scroll back up to our function, we can paste this in. Make sure they're indented correctly though at the same level. And before we were using their variable u, but now it's got to be the input parameter user, so we can change the u to user. So that will all match up correctly. So we're going to print, then deleting the user, and then we're going to use the user del command to delete the user. So we mustn't forget to put the delete function back into args.delete, but rather than the code that we have before, we're now going to use our user-defined function, del user, and of course we'll be deleting the user variable u in this case. So that should be back up and running now. Now, of course, when you look at it like this, you can say, well, I've got the same functionality as I had before. Why am I creating then the user-defined function? Well, the function we had before, we had to specify the users at the command line, but we want to add in a new parser argument that will allow us to delete users based on the content of a file, just in the same way we can create users based on the content of the file. So we're going to add that argument in now. So first of all, we add the parser argument in, and we can use pretty much any switch that we want that's not being used. So I can then use then minus R for remove, let's say. And then we can use in the option delete from file, or minus minus delete from file. I've already put an if statement where I'm checking for this, so I might as well keep it consistent. And then we can close that out and then put in our help information, so comma and help equals. And of course our specified text, so I'm just putting delete local accounts from file, much to match what we have above. So now we've got the functionality of the argument. That argument is going to be referenced within OpenFile. So OpenFile, we look to create users and delete users from file. And just looking at that, I've created my del user function, but I called it in here. I was calling the function delete user, so we'll just change this to del user so it matches. So of course we need to test for these conditions. So if we drop down to our if statements, and then we can start writing in. But let's just take a look at these if statements first. Got two if statements here. The expire is in an if statement all by itself, because we can use the expire parameter with creating users and creating users from file. But If we look at the other options that I have within the elif block, creating the user, deleting the users, adding users from file, well, these really are mutually exclusive options, so hence we're using the elif statement rather than independent if statement like we are with expire. So if we drop down and then start creating then our new option, so this is going to be making sure that's tabbed in correctly, elif, and then args dot, and we called it delete from file. So we'll have to be careful of typos. And then of course we're running then our new open file function, the user defined function that we created, and we're going to open the file args.delete from file. So with this in place then we should be able to test it. So with the file saved and returning to our shell, let's first of all let's go through and delete this single user. So this is going to be the minus D option. And this will be then calling our del user function. So we can see that the function is working correctly, deleting the user, echoing out the text. But now let's check that it's deleting from file, so minus R and then the file name. So that was dot dot and then file one. And we see now we're correctly deleting the Abraham, Calvin, John, Bill and Ronald accounts. So you can see the functionality that we've been able to add to our script using these user-defined functions and allowing us then to be able to create users at the command line or from a file. And equally, of course, being able to delete them both from the command line and from the file.